once more. Two, three, and. So I'm going to try some things with you, and I want you to pay attention, because some of you are getting a chance to come up here and do what I do, to conduct. All right? So watch this. I want you to play that B-flat as I show it to you. So how would you play that B-flat if I showed you this? Ready to play? Good. Yeah. Responsive. You follow directions very well. What about this? Ready? So we are going to warm up with a few scales. B flat major scale. B flat major. Right. Think about your key signature. We're just getting some sound in the room here. Here we go. Let's go up in quarter notes. Up in quarter notes and then right back down. No confusions about it. One, two, three, and.
Thank you.
whether it's happy or sad, major or minor, right? So if you ever wonder why things sound happy or sound sad, it's because of that third note. It could be raised or it could be lowered, right? Now play that same scale with a lowered third and a lowered seventh. Here we go. One, two, three, and. Sometimes they happen in different arrangements. So take out the second scale degree and take out the sixth scale degree. So don't play two and don't play six. You're going to skip right over them. Right? Here we go. One, two, three, and. What? To get the rhythm. Okay, so maybe your band director at some point in your life says, we gotta sing the rhythm so we're all singing together. Anyone else? Anyone else? Why do we sing in band class? Yes.
To visualize what you're gonna play.
Very good. You gotta see yourself play it successfully. What else? Anything else? What about intonation? Right? Intonation. If you can sing something in tune, can't you play it in tune as well? Let's see if you can do it. Play it. Here we go. On.
Thank you.
Yeah, give him a hand. What's your name? David, nice to meet you. All right, very good, young man. Okay. All right, this is the last one, though. He was up here smiling. He was like, no, I'm not going to let you stop. That's it. I'm not going to go on with it. All right, what's your name? Rachel, nice to meet you, Rachel. Sierra Oaks. All right. You ready? You've seen this a few times now. So you think you can do it on your own? Maybe. I feel like you have the confidence to do it. I think you can, right? Yeah, for sure. All right, count them off. Tell them to keep going or tell them to stop. But remember that we got to end sometimes. Ready? One, two, or one, two, three. Switch gears to Louie Louie. Right. Womp womp womp. Womp 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 womp. Womp 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 womp. We're gonna have this young man come up. He's gonna start us off. Right? We'll play the melody a few times, then you're gonna see this. Bass line, keep it coming, rhythm section, keep it coming. And that pentatonic scale, that B-flat scale that we're playing, is a really great tool to use for improvisation. We're gonna have a microphone over here. And we're gonna have a microphone over there. So I'll start moving around in formal line, whatever you want to use. Okay, you ready? So I know a lot of you play in jazz bands at the middle school level. Jazz bands in the middle school level, or at least you wanted to, or you experimented with playing jazz. But remember that jazz is the only genre where you have improvisation. Now, Louie Louie is not a jazz tune. You can solo on anything. You can solo on Mozart and Bach, and you can solo on Lady Gaga, and you can solo on anything. Right? You can. It's just being creative and making music. So that's what we're going to start out with. So remind me your name. Jackson. Everyone say hi to Jackson. We know Jackson. You know Jackson. So what Jackson's gonna do is, because I trust you, I'm gonna turn it over to him. He's gonna start you off. He's gonna give you all this. And at whatever point you feel like we play the melody enough times, maybe three or four times or something like this, give him the signal, right? For all the wind players to cut out. No more Louie Louie, but the rhythm section and the bass line, we're gonna keep on going for our soloist. And because you're so brave, you can take the first solo. Does that make sense? Okay, and then at that point, if you want to come up and play with a high schooler, if you want them to play a duet with you or a trade for us or something like this, that's totally fine. But if you want to come up and play on your own, right, you stand up and play the melody or play the bass line or do whatever you want to do, you can